Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. If it's your first time here, welcome and happy new year. Hopefully this is ends up being the first video of the year. It is New Year's Eve day as I'm recording this, and I am currently serving the last day of a ban on YouTube due to a strike on a video that didn't at all break YouTube's rules. Anyway, so happy new year to me. End of the year, can't post any videos. This will be the first one of 2023, so let's get into it. So, a little different video. I'm not reviewing anything. I'm not doing any shooting. Well, I might do a little bit of shooting. Probably not, though. Today I will be, though. I'm recording videos today. I just kind of wanted to do a quick recap of 2022, what to expect in 2023, a little bit about the channel if you're new here, wrap it up at that. So if you don't already know me, my name is Matt, and this is the RTT Guns and Gear channel. Now, I want to start right there, a little history of the channel. I get asked quite often what RTT stands for. It's not my initials, it's not a business that I own. What does RTT stand for? Well, I'm going into my 11th year on YouTube right now. And at the end of this year, I'm right at 34, just north of 34,000 subscribers. Not real good performance. Especially when you think about channels that are 2 years old that have 100,000 subscribers for whatever reason, whatever voodoo magic they've been able to dip into, I have not found. But hopefully by the end of 2023, I hit 50. And if you could help me out with that, that'd be awesome. But this is my 11th year in YouTube. And my channel name was originally Resist the Tyranny, because that is exactly what my channel, the core of my channel, has always been about. Now, I understand that some of you may know me from reviews, maybe even some training videos, things like that. But the core of my channel, especially if you look at other social media that I'm on, where I have more freedom posts, you know, type thing, Resist the Tyranny is the original name of my channel. I'm very, very, very a staunch supporter of the Second Amendment as it is written. There is no interpretation of the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment is very plain to me. And every gun law is unconstitutional. And that's exactly how my channel started. I was the first channel, other than maybe one other one, but I was the first channel that did almost completely and solely Second Amendment news, updates, things like that. Of course, there was other news stories involving politics and freedom that I would do as well and cover, but that was how my channel originally started. And but it's always been Second Amendment motivated. It's always been Second Amendment centric. Now, I stopped doing that about 4 years, I guess, into it. Maybe 4 years into it, because it wasn't something that was taking off very much. I was called a conspiracy theorist quite often by even some of the people that today are seeing and complaining about the things that people like me were warning about a decade ago or more. And so I ended up moving out here to Arizona from Ohio, and was able to all of this great public land that we are able to shoot on out here, and was able to delve more into the hands-on shooting aspect, which is something I've been a lifelong student and practitioner of. I started shooting when I was 8 years old. First two guns I ever shot was an M1 carbine and a snub-nose 38 Smith. That's when I was 8 years old. So I didn't even shoot a 22 rifle that most people intend to grow up on until I was well into my late teens. So I've been a shooter my whole life. I have done many, many classes. I haven't done any in the last handful of years, but I intend to hopefully do some this year. Get a couple, you know, any good teacher, which I do on the side, by the way, any good teacher will also take classes from other people, because there's always something new to be learned. But I was able to focus my attention and energy on the actual art, the actual hands-on approach to defending your freedom, so to speak, and that is there are certain ways to keep your freedom and to make your voice heard. The soapbox, the ballot box, cartridge box, and of course the jury box, and the jury soapbox and ballot box seem to do no good anymore, and so I firmly believe there's a day that we will need to vote from the cartridge box. That may sound extreme to some people. My mindset is that. That may not be your mindset, but it is what it is, and it's a beautiful thing about freedom. So, moved to Arizona brings me to today, where I've been able to do many training videos, many gun and gear reviews and things like that, and brings me to a poll that I asked you guys out there in YouTube land in the community section of what you would want to see more of in 2023. 2022, I did a lot of sort of experimentation with the way I record videos and things like that. And, adding things here, doing things a little different there, intros and whatnot. And you guys have resoundingly said that gear setups, gun and gear setups was the primary thing you would look forward to, and then training videos after that. And so I would expect to see more of that from me, more of those two things from me in 2023. I didn't do many training videos in 2022, but you asked for it, and that's what I'm going to give you. Sorry about the cough. I have been sick for the last week. Now, you'll still see reviews from me in 2023, because that's sort of a easy bread and butter thing. You know, I get something, I use it for a month, 3 months, sometimes longer, and give you my opinion on how it performed. Tell you about the product, give my opinion on how it performed over that period of time, and let you make your mind up about whether or not something you like or want to invest in. But those are really the easy videos to make. They're not necessarily the most cost-effective videos to make, but they're the easy videos to make. So you're gonna see plenty of reviews, of course, because, again, they're sort of a no-brainer. Now, as far as 2023 goes, one person asked specifically about close-quarter stuff. Now, I don't have readily available access to always having close quarters area to train in, although here and there I do, and that is something that I want to do some training bits on this year, because most situations people are in are not out here in the middle of the desert or in the middle of the woods. Most people are in their homes, in a store, in a mall, something like that, where a lot of close quarter stuff is more applicable. I also have several old training videos where I was recording with a potato, and the production quality was, for lack of better words, trash, that I'm going to remake some of those, starting even from like beginner type training stuff all the way to advanced stuff. So look forward to some of those remakes of videos from 6-8 years ago to probably show up in 2023. Now in 2022, I've delved a lot into optics. I started delving into pistol comps, and I started delving into pistol red dots. Now, I'd been running a Vortex Venom red dot for a long time, for, I don't know, 2 or 3 years, 4 years, something like that. And it refuses to die. It's a great red dot. I just bought a Holosun. I recently reviewed the Siley Wolf Zero budget red dot. I've had a couple little small issues with it. I'm working with Siley to get those fixed or to get those addressed, and I'll be making another video in the future based on that. So in 2022, I did a lot of LPVOs. You'll see some more LPVOs in this coming year, but you're also going to see more pistol red dots in the coming year, and probably compensators, because compensators, especially the compensators and pistol red dots, as far as those go, they're becoming more and more prevalent, and I want to be educated about those for when you ask me questions, or when you have questions that you're trying to purchase one, you can find hopefully those answers in some video where I've done a review and I've used that. So I want to be more educated in those subjects of compensators and pistol red dots, and hopefully through my education process of getting more of them and using them, I also am able to educate you at the same time. So one thing that you should also expect to see from me in 2023 is suppressor content. Not like a lot of it, but I have put my form in. I have purchased a suppressor. I'm just waiting for the approval. And it is a Otter Creek Polonium suppressor. Everything I see on it is really good, and it's very affordable. So we'll see more. You'll see that in 2023 as well. Now, unfortunately for a couple people, one thing you probably won't see much of is the vlog type videos. I played around with like overland adventure videos a couple years ago, and they didn't do very well. They have a lukewarm reception at best, and there's only a handful, and when I say handful, maybe 2 to 5 people that ever ask about them. And while I strive to give everybody what they want as well as I can, it also has to be worth my time and effort, because these videos aren't free to make, and especially when you're talking about adventuring to places out in the hills and mountains at just gas prices alone, it can get expensive to do traveling like that. So unfortunately, unless I go to an event like I did twice this year, which I'll get to in a second, unless I go to an event, you'll probably not see many vlog, if any, vlog videos from me this year. Now, as far as traveling goes, I do hope to hit a couple more events this year in 2023. In 2022, I went to My Medics camping trip up in northern Utah. That was a blast. Great people. They did a really good medical class while we were there. And then I also went to the Arizona Firearms Festival, met a lot of cool people. Met Mr. Big Kid, which was cool. He's a great guy, real down to earth, super nice dude. The Gun Collective, great guy there. We like shooting. Just everybody was really cool that I was able to meet from YouTube land, and hopefully I can continue some sort of a relationship with those guys this year and throughout the rest of YouTube. As far as other YouTubers go, one other thing that you definitely will be seeing in 2023 is I'm hoping to work with more YouTubers in the area this year. Desert Tactical over in Yuma. We have yet to meet, but he's been a big supporter of the channel. I'm hoping that I have supported his channel sufficiently, but Desert Tactical, cool guy, Southwest Gunner, got to shoot with him a few weeks back, a couple months ago, something like that, and Bug Out Bundy. So those three guys, and hopefully get to do some work with them this year. Also, a photographer named, her Instagram is Caliber Row. And I'm going to put links to all these people that I'm mentioning down below. Caliber Row Instagram. She's super cool, and I've worked with her one other time before, and hopefully I can continue that with her as far as getting not just content for her, but more content for my channel on a very high professional level like she works at. Speaking of Instagram, see how this is kind of flowing into each other. Speaking of Instagram, I'm going to be paying a lot more attention to Instagram this year. I want to build that up. More reels, more shooting videos as opposed to just still pictures, more reels and shooting videos. I'm also going to be doing more shorts for YouTube, the little 1 minute videos, probably just shooting videos, probably testing out something or a quick training tip or something like that. But more shorts on YouTube and more reels and Instagram posts and stories in 2023. Now, I still do train people on the side. That hasn't been very busy lately. There's a number of things that I'm sure goes into that because I've talked to other local instructors here that said they have been not as busy as they have been in the past. But I also train people on the side, and I also have my citizen militia group that I started back in 2015. We still put the work in, although I don't put it on camera as much as I used to. So I still put the work in with those guys as well. So that is it for 2022, beginning of 2023. What to expect, what to expect to see more of. Still kicking, still going at it. I'm throwing everything I can at the channel this year. I got another camera for multiple camera angles. Hopefully in the next month or two, you'll start seeing drone footage because I plan on getting a drone. And then of course, old trusty here that I always record on. And yeah, hopefully I'm gonna kick everything up a notch, throw everything I have in 2023, hopefully hit that 50,000 subscriber mark. Just sort of give me that reason, help give me that reason to keep chugging along. Yeah, keep doing this. Keep doing this for me, I enjoy doing it. Keep doing it for you because I hope to not just spread the message of freedom, but also educate and inform you on whatever it is that I may have, whether it's a cheap product or an expensive product, it doesn't matter to me. I'm gonna give you my experiences with it either way. Thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget to hit that like, share, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Hit all notifications so you can get more content from me. If you want to become a member of the channel, you can do so from the homepage of my channel. You can also go over to Ko-Fi, which is sort of a Patreon thing, but Patreon and Subscribestar didn't want me. So I found Ko-Fi. You can get video previews and members only type content as well. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you later.